Thank goodness I put a grow of big tomatoes in last fall. We did not know this was coming. We just thought a lot of people travel so much here that if they go on that cruise ship and they miss the, you know, 3 weeks, 6 weeks. I mean, I had a customer come in 6 months on a cruise ship going through the southern whatever. So this is a travel town. Well, when you come back, I wanted you to not have to catch up, just here. Instantaneous. Just tell your neighbor you got in yesterday. Oh yeah, I picked my first tomato. How was yours? This is why we grew these, but what we're finding is a lot of folks are buying these, not traveling. They just want bigger, instant vegetables. And so these we grew in this pot to stay in the pot. You would not have to plant it. We have a whole series of pots that we put together that are made for planting a tomato. So you don't want this ugly thing to be on your deck. You can put it in this and it would instantly go the season right here in this size pot. This would be the minimum size I would grow a tomato or pepper. I spray paint my tomato cages different colors just for fun. I have a half art. I like the artistry of gardening too. I'll spray paint them red or green or orange or bright blue, whatever. And I'll put them in my containers or in the gardens, and they'll grow up through that. It's pretty. But there's something magical about a tomato with a pretty cage at your front door with tomatoes on it that just people go, wow, that's a neat idea. Tomatoes are one of those few plants that you can plant deep and it will root more. So if you look up and down the stem of a tomato plant, you'll see hairs. If you're to plant this in the ground, I would literally plant this I'd almost pitch off all of these bottom foliage so that I could expose more of this stem, so I could literally plant it that deep. And then all those hairs will turn into roots. Do not do that with your peppers. If you look at too much soil on top of an eggplant, it wants to die. If you get too any, you'll get crown rot like that. But tomatoes, one of those unique plants where you can actually plant it deep, it'll encourage more roots, which means more produce, more harvest for you. That's one tip I can give you. Second on tomatoes, stay away from the really big tomatoes, like Brandywine, beefsteak, anything that has any big in it. Here, because the nights are so cold, they just don't produce. I mean, we're notorious for it's almost the first frost date, October, about Halloween. You haven't picked one tomato yet it's loaded up with green tomatoes, and we're about to have a frost tonight. I like to grow medium size or smaller fruits. I love the cherries, beefsteak, sweet 100s, yellow pears. They're beautiful. Half of them don't even make it in the house. They're just so sweet off the vine. I'm eating them right there. And then I like the medium-sized fruits, early girls, because I'm a salsa garden. I like that tangy acidity. I like Champion, Cherokees, German greens, anything that's medium-sized or smaller fruits, you'll find that you have better production. It's only because the night times get so cold, it's going to produce for you, trust me. If you're a Brandywine person, you've always grown that, you grew that with your grandparents, do it. Just realize you're gonna be covering that thing at the end of, through November to get your first tomato off. And it'll be a beautiful slicer, but it just is harder to produce. That's the thing.